Party, Dr. D. Sudhakar Jonaragadda, President Direct Office. I could see that his medical profession has got a good the outset. Let me congratulate the American Association of Physicians of Indian Origin for organizing this Global Health Summit in Hyderabad today. I am told that API, founded in 1982 by a group of Indian American medical professionals, was conceived to deal with immigration and licensing issues faced by foreign medical graduates in USA. I am happy to know that today API is the largest non-profit ethnic medical organization in USA, protecting the interest of more than 60,000 practicing physicians and 20,000 medical students, residents and fellows of Indian origin. It is truly noteworthy that many of the API members hold numerous leadership positions in the academia. I am glad to learn that API serves as an umbrella organization with a network of over 160 chapters across USA. We are indeed proud of our doctors and healthcare practitioners who are rendering invaluable healthcare services in countries across the globe. It has been estimated that there are 1.4 million physicians of Indian origin all over the world. I am told that 1 in every 7 patients in USA is being treated by a physician of Indian origin at a given time. We feel really proud that our doctors are doing such a great job. I applaud API for being a dynamic body, spearheading legislative agendas and influencing the advancement of medical care, not only in the US, but across the globe. My dear sisters and brothers, today India is the fastest growing economy in the world. We are moving towards becoming the $5 trillion economy by 2025 at a steady pace. India is the world's largest proportion of young people. Half of its population is under the age of 25. And we have reforms happening in full swing. The Prime Minister gave a three-line advice. He said reform, perform and transform. Transform the nation. Transformation in every field. That is what is required for the country. We are an ancient civilization. We have a great heritage, culture, traditions and knowledge. India once upon a time was known as Vishwaguru. Students from across the globe, they used to come to India, study here in Nalanda, Takshashila, Prashnagiri, Vikramshila, in all these places. This is not what we are saying ourselves. Yuan Song, Pua Hian, the Chinese historian of the period, they came and wrote about India and its greatness and genesis. So that being the case, it's quite but natural that we are moving forward. In between there was a setback because of a colonial rule. Colonial rule. They came, they ruled, they ruined, they looted, they cheated, and they cheated some of our minds also. That's the problem. The British people not only looted and cheated our money, but also our minds also. That's why we are suffering with that disease now. They are great and we are inferior and all. We must come out of that. We must come out of that. The World Bank, World Economic Forum, International Monetary Fund, Asian Development Bank, Moody's Ratings, not Modi's Ratings, Moody's Ratings. Everybody is saying that India, if it moves with the same speed and if there is unity and if the velocity of the reforms is taken up further, India will become the third largest economy in the world. This is what everybody is saying. Thanks to the initiative of not only government, but also people in the business, people in the industry, people in various professions, like you all, are responsible for the present situation. It's a collective work done by all people, different stakeholders of the country. I feel very happy when I go abroad as a Vice President of India, earlier as a Minister, I used to go around and everywhere now India is being recognized and respected everywhere. Because one is of course our ancient civilization and culture, tradition, our love for peace, Second is because of our economy is moving stronger. The Western countries look at the economy more than anything else.